From performing on European stages to Apollo Theatre in New York, Gregory Keke Mabusela of the Muffinz fame has now embarked on a new journey as a solo artist. We chat to him today about his musical journey and his latest offering as a solo artist called Kwanzaa, an ode to the powerful and strong African woman. Doing. It's so lovely to see you.
I'm awesome, Palisa. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Kwanzaa impela butwam. What a beautiful song. I mean, what a powerful message.
No, I'm glad that everyone is receiving the song so well, and it's blessing a lot of people. Yes.
Yeah, definitely doing its job. But first, we want to chat to you about your musical journey, you know, where your love for music began. So please, may you share that with us.
You know, so it all began in my grandmother's house, which is a four-room house in Naledi, a location in Soweto, where I was born. And I remember vividly when I was about 6 or 7, when I saw Ntateza Leif Keita on TV singing Africa. And I mean, he was singing in a foreign language, and I understood what he was saying somehow. And I pointed at the screen and said that one day when I grow up, I want to be like that man.
Oh, wow. And what powerful steps to kind of walk into, because that is a man where you just need to say Salif and everyone knows who you're talking about. What a powerful, incredible story, saying that, you know, you started from the bottom and now you're here. You know, you have come from a very successful musical band, The Muffinz, and now you've decided to launch your own solo career. I mean, why was this so important for you to do?
Why now? I think it was really about time for me to tell my truth. And I love the Muffinz so much because we respect each other's creatives. And even outside of the band, we've been doing work. I've been doing theater for the last 3 years now, or 4 years now. And other guys have also been embarking in other journeys, you know. And so it was not even a hard decision for me to do my solo. So it was really a blessed go ahead from the band. And I just think it is time. I mean, I've been in the industry for more than 10 years now. And I thought it is time for the world to hear my story and hear my spiritual language, which is the Kekelingo, yeah.
Now let's talk about you creating your own language and instrument. Give us everything there is to know about why you decided to do this.
Firstly, spirituality is a very big factor for me, and this is what my grandmother passed on to me, because she used to take me to church, and I remember at church sometimes they would preach and I would not even understand, but every time they would sing, I would lose my mind. And for me, I took that and I ran with it. And I remember even after the passing of my mother, during the mourning process, I would find myself singing in these like tongues, or I'd call them chants. And I started recording these chants on my cell phone. And before I knew it, I was like, wait, I think there is something here. And I prayed on it, and I would spend more time in this creative process. And this is how we have the Kekelingo today.
I love the fact that you're just allowing yourself to go where the tongue leads you, because it's very important for you as a creative to be honest, to be authentic, and to be genuine in and grounded in what you're doing. And I also love the fact that I'm seeing the thread here from not being able to understand uPapa Salif singing, and you also listening to the people abakhonzayo esontweni, and also not being able to understand it. So you've decided to create your own universal language, your own universal tongue. young. And there's power in that too. Now, as a creative, how has COVID-19 affected you personally?
Wow, okay, COVID-19 is here, and as a creative, obviously a lot of the festivals and a lot of the corporate shows, events that we booked for were all cancelled, which obviously will affect the pocket, you know, financially. But I also find comfort in the sense that it has offered me the time to like self-reflect and work on myself as a human being and to better myself. And I found myself meditating a lot and praying a lot. And this is how I get most downloads of the music that you hear. Songs like Konza, this is from all the downloads. In the nighttime when I'm sleeping, I get downloads, and I would wake up and have my phone on record mode and record whatever download that I would get. So I can say, yes, it is a bummer that COVID-19 is here. And obviously it has affected everyone from all industries, you know. But I think for me, from a spiritual realm and point of view, I've gained so much. I think I'm a better human being right now.
Now speak to us about your labor of love, your debut single, Konza.
Oh, where do I even start? So, first of all, Konza is a song that is inspired by my mother, my grandmother, and my sister. All these queens are on the other side. They are not on earth anymore. They raised me, and I am the man that I am today, and it's because of them, you know. So basically, it's a thank you to these amazing queens that have raised me, and also the experiences that as a young man that I had in my grandmother's house, and I'm just so grateful for these amazing women. Wow. And so I thought it was only fitting for me to have this song, Konza. And Konza means ukubulisa. Konza means to send your greetings. So it's me sending greetings from Earth to the realm that they are now, you know. And just to say, your works didn't go in vain. I am here. I am a strong young man, and it's because of you.
And as you already have dedicated this song to the strong, powerful women in your life, do you have a message for the men of South Africa? We have seen an incredible increase of gender-based violence and abuse on women and children. And we are standing up as Afternoon Express, and we are saying no more, enough is enough. But you know, we need the men to stand by our sides and share the same sentiment. So on that note, what message do you have for the men of South Africa, calling them to order?
It starts at home. I myself grew up without a father. And for me to see a man hit a woman, that means that's easy for you to do that to your own mother. Because women are the economy of the world. Men, please, it has to stop. And let's start at home. Posting about it is not enough. It starts at home, how you are taught. Respect starts at home. So I'm pleading with men, with South African men, with men all over the world,
yes,
to say, let us respect the mother. Respect women. Women is the mother. So yes, like that's all I can say about this.
Thank you so much for that message, Gregory, because I have to call you with respect, you know. Thank you so much for sharing that message and reminding us, South Africa, that the hard work starts at home. So if you are a guardian, if you find yourself as the man and the leader of a household, as you so proudly say, be the change. Thank you so much, Keke. We appreciate it. Cheers, Butwam.
Thank you so much, Palesa. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. So everyone, we do encourage you to go out there and go download Konza. Let's support Kekelingo in his urge to celebrate and uplift as an ode to powerful, strong women.